عمر سام وحفص his daughter. Did you? They did not ask. They start. They start denying. And Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, he tried to bring each one of them to talk to her individually. And Aisha said, Ya Rasulullah, don't do that. Let me talk to them. Aisha, she was a leader of them. She was the youngest, but she was a leader of them. Yeah. May Allah be blessed with them. They are the mothers of the believers. What happened is, Aisha radiallahu anha, she sit with all of them and she convinced them, khalas, we'll accept whatever. Ya Rasulullah, how can, you know, if you divorce us, we'll die. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala declared that in the Holy Quran. Allah said it, Surah Al-Tahrim. Said, Asa Rabbuhu in talaqakun. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala divorce him from you guys, from you, the mothers of believers, Asa Rabbuhu an yubdilahu azwajan khayr min kun. He will exchange you with wives better than you. And Allah described their characteristics. Muslimat, good in Islam. Muslimat means they have full submission to Allah and His Messenger more than you. Mu'minat, they are mu'minat. They believe in the oneness of Allah and the Quran, His Messenger. Qanitat. Qanitat means obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Standing, praying at night. Obedient does not mean the mothers of the believers, they did not do that. They were, but more than that. Muslimat more than you. Mu'minat more than you. Khanitat more than you. But does not mean they were not. They were. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling them this is a way. Khanitat. Ta'ibat. Always they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abidat. Good worshipper to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sa'ihat. Sa'ihat. That lady which is, she can sit with you and she's thinking a lot of thoughts about the greatness of Allah, the capability of Allah, the subhanAllah, the azama of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or sa'iha means sa'ihat, yani she's traveling herself and thinking about the greatness of Allah in the universe. Sa'ihat, thayyibatin wa abkar. Thayyibat al-mar'a thayyib, that lady she's thayyib, she's been married before, and abkar, she's still virgin. You can mix both of them. This is a message from Allah to us also. Some of us, mashallah, you want to marry? Yes. Yeah. Virgin or she been married before? No. Virgin. What about that sister? No, forget her. She's been married before. This haram. Allah giving us message here, even Rasulullah, I will marry him from what? Thayyib. Thayyib, she's not ashamed. Because in my country, for example, in Egypt, in the villages, maybe in your countries too, any lady, her husband died, South Africa, or she been divorced, bishop, the one she been divorced, no, nobody's looking at her. People humiliating her, even her family too. They treat her very badly. This is our countries, our cultures. You know, any lady she been married before, or she been divorced, especially the one she been divorced. They treat her very bad, like a slave. And you go, marry her, no, her husband died, no. She's shooting, you know, shooting and bad luck. She has bad luck, you know. Maybe I will marry her, I will die. She killed her husband. This is what people think. Or she's, yes, she been divorced, means she was very bad. This is not right. Because Allah told the Rasulullah, I will marry you from Thayyib. Thayyib bad. Women, they've been married before. And all the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they've been married, all of them before, except Aisha. All of them, they've been married before Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And most of them, they were older than him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Except Aisha, the only wife, he married her virgin, while she was virgin. For that mar'a, that lady, she'd been married before, she's not ashamed. She's not something bad, you know. So we have to look at this woman too, haram. She needs somebody to keep her dignity, to take care of her, because if nobody gonna look at her, she gonna make zina, you know. She has a right. That's why we've been asking the brothers, Look to the sisters. We have in our societies, especially nowadays in the time of war and killing of men, too many women, unmarried women. And unmarried men also because of that very bad life now, everything expensive, and people, women, the youth, they have no, the young brothers, they have no money to marry. I make a book before like 7 years, more than 7 years. And I put that percentage in special Middle East, like my country, Egypt. 1995, we are 2016, right? Almost done. Yeah, 1995, in Egypt, for each Egyptian lady, each Egyptian man, he can marry 9 Egyptian women to cover up the society. And only 10% of the Egyptian men, they marry every year because of the poverty. And we have women being divorced, we have women widows, we have women her husband died, we have women already, they never been married. Same thing in Jordan, same thing worse than Egypt, Saudi Arabia. See how much money they have? Too many women without marriage and married women. More in Palestine, more in Iraq because of the war. Iraq, all of this, since the time of Iran and Saddam, war. Too many people been killed. Libya now.
Syria,
oh, Iraq, Syria, don't talk about Syria, مساكين. I feel sorry for them. يعني if you go Egypt, anybody here from Syria, don't be mad at me. If you go Egypt, most of them, some of them, they go Egypt. They go Jordan. They go different countries. Europe countries, you know, even from the news. Egyptian man telling me, Sheikh, if you have $200, I can get you most of your Syrian lady in Egypt to marry her. With $200. With $200. I forgot, he told me $200 Egyptian pound or dollars. See, I'm telling you, why? Education. And the Sham women, they are very beautiful women, to be honest with you. The most beautiful women in all Arab, Sham area. Sham means the Muslim and Syria. That is what I'm saying. Including, you can say Lebanon and also Palestine and Jordan. This is the Lebanon area. Sham area.
Afghanistan,
I forgot to say too. Afghanistan because of the war. You're right. Yes, Afghanistan too. Yes, I forgot, sorry. Yes, that's fact. Yes. Too many unmarried women in Afghanistan too. Where the war, this is too many unmarried women. Saha or Samra?
Unless you forgot Tunisia,
but Tunisia, alhamdulillah, there is no war there.
There is a war between husbands and wives. Biggest war.
Who's the victim?
The stronger. Both of them.
That's good. One by one, خلاص. Okay. One of the ways of being happy, inshallah, to have a pious wife, and you have to look for this lady. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Tunsah al-mar'a li-arba'." Women being married for four reasons: for her beauty. Beauty is very important. Yes, if she's beautiful, it's good. Why not? But the beauty for me, it is not the beauty of the face. It's nisbi, the spirit of the heart. Yes. Don't think the beauty of the face. No, beauty of the face can go any time.
Okay, the beauty of the face matters too.
I can give 20% of it. 20%, not too much.
Give her 50, please.
No, 50. Let me tell you something, because I will tell you something. Khadra ibn, that lady, which is Rasulullah called her, it's a good hadith, but it's the right hadith. That woman, which is Khadra ibn, Rasulullah called her. Khadra ibn, al-mar'a al-sayyi' al-jamila fil manbat al-su', the beautiful lady, but she grew up in very bad society. She's kharbana. Completely no akhlaq, no manners. That lady, forget her. You see, lady, the most beautiful lady in the world, but you feel she has no heart, like a mommy.
She's not listening to you.
She's not listening. She has no spirit. She has no heart.
Beautiful, Yes.
No communication. What do you need from her beauty? Her green eyes. I don't need this green eyes. She's gonna feed me with her green eyes. I need somebody to communicate, to make me happy, This is a beauty. This is a beauty. The beauty of the roh, not the beauty of the face and all of that stuff. No, forget this.
It's important in the morning when you say you face.
They say the moon is beautiful, but the moon is dirt. Right? The moon is dirt. All the poets in Arab and non-Arab days, the moon, the 9th to 14th, they said beautiful like the moon. The moon, sir. This is what they say. تنكح المرأة, to marry women for what? For her money too, wealth. Why not? To help you, that's good. And for her, what? Also family and tribe, that's good. If she's from good family, you make sure your kids are gonna be good also, like the family, the roots. And the most important for her deen. So as I said, فَظْفَرْ بِذَاتِ الدِّينِ تَرِبَتْ يَدَكَ. Take the one which has deen, your hand will be full. تَرِبَتْ يَدَكَ, your hand will be full. This is what Rasulullah said. But this is one thing. If you have that pious wife, this is way of happiness, you will be happy. Second, if you have a big house, you also mashallah, that enough for your family and you're enjoying your kids, that house big enough, that also you're going to be happy. All if you have a good neighbor, your neighbor is not troublemaker, it's not giving you hard time. And the neighbor is very important in Islam. And they look to American society. If you say this bad neighbor, no, the house is very bad there. You know, low price. If you go somewhere and very good neighborhood, oh, the house is very high, you know. You have to pay money for this. And Asia, the wife of Fir'aun, what did she ask Allah? She did not ask Allah for Jannah. She did ask Allah for Jannah with its condition. What's the condition? رَبِّ ابْنِ لِي عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. Oh Allah, I need a house in Jannah near to you. She choose الجار, the neighbor, before the door, before the house. She choose the neighbor, which is Allah, before the house. I know I'm going to go to Jannah, but I don't know, I don't want to go to any Jannah. I want to be neighbor to Allah. Close to Allah. عِنْدَكَ at you. عِنْدَكَ بَيْتًا فِي الْجَنَّةِ. This is what she said. Yes, the wife of Fir'aun. You have to choose your neighbor. If you have a good neighbor, you're happy. If you have a good house, big house, you're happy. If you have a good ride, you will be happy to. Imagine you have that car, 1950, and you're in 405. It's not working. Everybody called that terrible, whatever. Are you terrible A? And you, every time, what's wrong? That car is not working. Every day, I want to go to Fajr. It's not working. No. Rasulullah said, if you have a good ride, that also will make you happy. When you sit, you put the heater, you put the cooler, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, tawakkalna Allah, it's working. You know, that will not give you big problem, you know. But this is four things, inshallah. If you do it, inshallah, you will be happy in your life, inshallah. Exactly.